instrument second to you.
Yeah.
And like, how many of you started on your instrument in either a heavy band or a campus band? Like, starting on your instrument in either marching band or campus band?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, lots of people are coming. So it's a huge, you know, it's a huge leap for someone to just jump into this, never having played an instrument in their life, let alone, you know, just having a musical experience prior. So I'm really proud of all my friends in this group. The music score was really hard. And we only had six rehearsals of that. Because we only meet Fridays from 4 to 6 p.m. And we started after picnic day when most of these people were available. So, six rehearsals. Really proud of the work they put together. This last piece is called Future Perfect. It's my senior project. I've been working on this for a while. I think a quarter and a half I've been working on this piece. My composition teacher, Laurie Seth Martin, I don't know if she's in the conversation. A lot of pointers. Make this more messy is my favorite thing that you said to me. So I definitely took that to heart. Not these guys though, they're definitely not music players. So Future Perfect, first symphonic and everything, I'll read it. It says, it can be overwhelming to realize that no event on a timeline is certain until it has become the past. The future, by principle, is impossible to grasp. Yet language has one way of saying with complete certainty that something in the future will happen. The definition of the future perfect tense indicates that an action will happen, completed, finished, or perfected at some point in the future. Music is a form of art that happens through time. In Future Perfect, I sought to explore the ceaseless parade of time through motives that appear and develop. Some of the musical material of Future Perfect experiences steady development, while others are introduced at the start of the piece and never recur until the end. The people and events that make up our lives visit us in ways unpredictable, making friends, falling in love, saying goodbyes, letting people go. That's all part of the endless march of time. Future Perfect is my ode to time. The Future Perfect tense is affirmative and sure, despite the inherent uncertainty of the future. I never would have uttered the phrase, quote, by the end of my undergraduate career, I will have composed for and directed a concert band. But here
Good evening and welcome. For any of you who don't know, I'm Pete Allen, director of concert bands here at UC Davis, and I'm really pleased to welcome you this evening and to welcome you to join us now. I'm becoming very careful about this. A longtime friend of mine, Lisa Dalla. First, what you just heard, in addition to being the concert band director, many of you may know I'm also a choir teacher here. I am so gratified that we are now fielding, 15 different horses playing tonight in two bands, and an 8-person ensemble. It's really great, and I have just a wonderful group, and I'm really pleased to showcase them in that piece by Ernesto de Colonna, Cuban composer, and arranged by a very good friend of mine from Sacramento, Christian Jones, the Malaguenia. We turn now to something very different, some Spanish songs. You will probably observe, though we haven't said, that there is a theme to this evening's program, in that it is music inspired by the Spanish language and music of Spanish language-speaking countries. The next piece is by a composer who attended UCLA at the University of Michigan. It was commissioned by the University of Michigan wind ensemble, Matthew Tomasini. And we're going to put three songs in this set. And you can see that it's a little bit different with an 8-player plus piano and percussion ensemble to accompany a couple of really beautiful songs. I'll just
Thank you.
Now, these next two examples are shorter. They really show the smaller versions. So that's all 7-8. Now, look at these little 7-16, which is that little one. And we'll hear how those grow out of the poem. Let's go to the next example.
Thank you. Thank you.
gestures and the movements of tango, the little bits and pieces that go together. And gradually those will coalesce into a tango, and then you'll hear several variations of that tango. And finally, the ultimate tango, for which he chooses the meter of 5/4, so it's a good thing we don't have to dance. We will take a tuning note before this and then perform the Antos y Pangos.
Thank you.
March of Mexico, President Argentina. But before we do that, this is